And welcome to my channel Incredible Biology. I am Nidhi Joshi. Welcome to all my dearest students and colleagues and who is watching this video tutorial. I hope you all are well and good at your home in this COVID-19 situation. In this COVID-19 situation, we are not able to teach you into the classroom and you all are not able to come at the college. So we find a way to reach you by this platform. So now we jump on to today's topic. In previous video, we discussed about unit 1 and classification of animal kingdom on the basis of various manner. The previous session, we already discussed about the first 5 parameters: habitat, shape and size, level of organization, body plan and symmetry. In today's session, we are going to discuss further parameters: body cavity or xylem, germ layer, metamerism, cephalization, appendages, organ system and body temperature. Now we are starting from the germ layers. Now what is a germ layer? It is a group of cell into the early embryo. They interact with each other as the embryo develops and contribute to for the formation of the all organs and the tissue. Body cavity and xylem, between them there is a germ layer is found. First one is a mesoderm, endoderm and ectoderm. There are main 3 germinal layer found in the animal's body: mesoderm, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. On the basis of development from the germinal layer, the animal divides into 2 groups: diploblastic and triploblastic. Now what is diploblastic animal? Diploblastic animals, di means 2 and blastic means germinal layer. The animal develops from the 2 germinal layers, and the 2 germinal layers are, first one is endoderm and the second one is ectoderm. Example is porifera, tenophora and ciliata. Triploblastic, what is the mean by triploblastic? Tri means 3 and blastic means germinal layer. The animal develops from the 3 germinal layer. First one is endoderm, second one is ectoderm and third one is mesoderm. Example, platyhelminthes to higher chordate are originates from these 3 germinal layer: endoderm, ectoderm and mesoderm. Here we can picturize these things. These are diploblastic animal and these are triploblastic animal. The diploblastic animal is originates and develops from the 2 germinal layer. First one is endoderm, the innermost layer, and the outermost layer, ectoderm. The middle layer and mesoderm are not found in these types of animal either. There is cells and there is a fluid filled in this layer. There is no true layer are found. The animal is called a diploblastic animal. The second one is a triploblastic animal. There is outermost layer, ectoderm is found. The innermost layer, endoderm is found. And ectoderm, and between ectoderm and endoderm, there is mesoderm is found. The animal is originates from these 3 layer: ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. So the animal is called triploblastic animal. Now we are further picturize these things. In this picture, you can see the in outermost layer that surrounds the ectoderm, endoderm, and outermost layer ectoderm that surrounds the mesoderm and endoderm. It forms the exoskeleton of the animal's body. The innermost layer endoderm surrounds by the mesoderm and ectoderm. It forms the inner lining of the organ, or it forms the gut or archenteron. And between both of them, ectoderm and endoderm, the mesoderm is found and it develops into the organs. Now we are discussing the further parameter, body cavity or xylem. Now what is body cavity and what is body cavity or xylem? Xylem means the body cavity, the cavity filled with cells or fluid present inside the body. In another language, it is formed during the embryo development from the germ layer. Body is formed during the embryonic embryonic development from the germ layers. The coelom is lined by the mesodermal epithelium cell. If the coelom is lined by mesodermal epithelium cell, hence it is a true coelom. Otherwise, it is not a true coelom. Presence or absence of the coelom inside the body is one of the characteristics for classifying the animals. The coelom is fluid filled. The definition of coelom, we can in scientific language, the coelom is a fluid filled body cavity present between the alimentary canal and body wall. Between the ectoderm and endoderm, there is a coelom lined by the mesodermal epithelial cell. This is known as coelom. We can classify it on the basis of how they are formed and origin. There are main three types of coelom or body cavity found in the animal. A coelomates. A means no, never, nothing. Coelom means cavity or body cavity. A coelomate means there is no body cavity or coelom present inside the body. Second one is a pseudo coelomates animal. Pseudo means false or coelom means cavity. It means there is a false or pseudo cavity or coelom present inside the body. Third one is eucoelomates or coelomates. It means there is a true body cavity is present inside the cells. Now we further discussing in deeper. A coelomates, there are no body cavity, or in another language filled with the cells up to the phylum Platyhelminthes. A coelomates are Porifera, Ctenophora and Platyhelminthes phylum. Porifera, Coelentrata, Ctenophora, Cnidaria and Platyhelminthes. Second is pseudo coelomates. Pseudo cavity is present and not lined by the mesodermal epithelium cell. Pseudo means false. It means there is a cavity, but the cavity is not lined by the mesodermal epithelial cell. If the cavity is lined by the mesodermal epithelial cell, it is known as pseudocoelom, or it is known as coelom or eucoelom. Cavity exists, but not mesoderm. Example is Aschelminthes. There is a pseudocoelom is found. There is one modification also. The modification in pseudocoelom, the modification is hemocoel. True cavity is reduced and the cavity between the ectoderm and endoderm filled with the circulatory fluids. The examples is Mollusca and Arthropoda contains the hemocoelom in their body. The third is eucoelom or coelomates. There is a true cavity is present and lined by the mesoderm. On the basis of its origin, further divides into two, cesocoelom and the anterocoelom type of coelom. Now what is cesocoelom? It is present in the protostomes. The body cavity or coelom originates from the splitting of mesoderm. One part attached to ectoderm and the other surrounds the endoderm. The space between them develops into the coelom. The blastopore forms the mouth. Example of cesocoelous animal are Annelida, Arthropoda and Mollusca. In Arthropoda and Mollusca, the hemocoelom is found. Another is anterocoelous type of coelom. It is present in deuterostomes animal. The coelom is formed from the fusion of the internal outgrowth of the archenteron or gut. It is a part of archenteron or gut. The pinches off and fuses together to form a coelom. They connect and pinches and fuses together to form a coelom. It is a part of gastrula. In early embryonic layer, this is found. The example of anterocoelous types of animal is Echinodermata and Chordata. Now we can picturize these things. Coelom. Here you can see all three coeloms: A coelom, pseudo coelom, and true coelom. Now we can understand these coeloms. There is ectoderm, the outermost germinal layer. There is endoderm, innermost germinal layer. Between them, there is no mesoderm, that is diploblastic enamel, and there is no cavity lined by mesodermal epithelium cell. So the enamel is acoelomate type of enamel. Second is a pseudoacoelom. There is outermost ectodermal layer, the innermost ectode, and the cavity is found, but the cavity is not lined by the mesodermal epithelial cell. So the cavity is known as a pseudocoelomic cavity, and the example is escalmentis. The third one, eucoelom or true coelom. Here is coelom, outermost layer ectoderm is found, innermost layer ectoderm is found, and between both of them there is mesodermal epithelial lining is found, it and the formation of coelom. It is called the true coelom and the coelomatic enamel. The example is Annelida to Chordata. Annelida, Mollusca and Annelida are the example of hemocoelom type of coelom. On the basis of development of schizocoelom and enterocoelom, there are splitting. There are early endoderm, early ectoderm, and the early mesodermal cell. The cells are splitting in the cell splits and form a coelom. It is called cell splits and form the coelom. Development of coelom. It is called schizocoelom type of animal. And in the enterocoelous type of animal, there are early ectoderm, there are early endoderm, and the connection of mesoderm with the archenteron or gut. It is separated from the separation of pouches of mesoderm of the gut and forms into the development of coelom. It is called enterocoelous type of animal. Now we jump onto the another parameter. It is a metamerism. Now what is the metamerism? In simplest language, the repetition of some structures in animal body is called the metamerism. It would be external or it would be internal. Metamerism would be external and metamerism would be internal. Now we are more understanding by this type of example. First one is Annelida. The metamerism is well shown in the Annelida phylum. There are internal as well as external metamerism is shown. The animal body divides by the externally by metameres and by internally by the septa. The animal body is segments. Animal body is divided into segments externally as well as internally, externally by the metameres and internally by the septa. So the true metamerism is seen in the Annelida. Another metamerism found in vertebrates. There are several structures only internally. Vertebrae, muscles and ribs are found repeated. So the in vertebrates animal only internal metamerism is seen. We can picturize these things. These are earthworm Annelida phylum's photo. You can see the external metamerism or external segments are found. These internal segments as well as in internal segments septa are found. The repeated structure in this septa and in these segments are found. So it is called the true metamerism. Second one is human skeleton picture. Here you can see the ribs are repeating structure. Internal metamerism is found. Here you can see the vertebras and vertebrae are repeated from anterior to posterior part of the body. These are the repeated internal metamerism, and there is also deposition of the muscles on pelvic girdle, on limbs. Depositions of muscles also, these are the repeated structure in human's body. So in human's body there are only the internal segmentation or internal repeated structure are found. Internal metamerism is found. And another example of arthropoda, there are only the external metamerism or external segmentation is found. Prothorax, mesothorax, metathorax and abdomen, these are the external segmentation found in the arthropoda phylum, only shows external metamerism. Here we can picturize these things. Jelly cirrhates, prosoma body divides into two metamerism, prosoma and opisthosoma, two segments. Here head and trunk, here head and pharynx and pelon, here head, thorax and abdomen. Head and thorax mix up with mix and made up of prothorax and mesothorax. So these are the metamerism found in the animals. Now we get on the another parameter is a syphilization. Now what is the syphilization? The concentration of sense organ or nerve control at the anterior end of the body forming head and brain both during evolution and in the course of embryonic development. Syphilization means is the formation of central nervous system in the organisms. Syphilization also means the differentiation of the anterior end of the organism into a definite head. It means concentration of the central nervous concentration of the nervous system towards the anterior part of the body, or in simple language we can say head formation of an organism. It is called syphilization. Head formation is due to the central nervous system. Ganglia and brain are developed into the anterior part of the body or into the head. Example is platyhelminthes, two chordates. Before that there is no head formation, and besides central nervous system, nerves and the neurons are found. In central nervous system, ganglia and brain are found. In higher vertebrate there is brain and spinal cord is found. In before that phylum there is no head. On besides central nervous system, nerves, neurons and nerve net is found into the animals. Now we can picturize these things. There is Hydra, early Cnidarian animal. There is no nervous system. There is only nerve net and there is no head formation. In echinoderms also there is nerve ring and radial nerves found. There is no appropriate nervous system. In planaria, in flatworms, from the platyhelminths there are development of brain, nerve cord and transverse nerve. In leeches there is brain, ventral nerve cord and segmental ganglia are found. In insects, arthropods, there are brain, vertebral nerve cord and segmental ganglia is found. In mollusca, further development of the nervous system, there are anterior nerve ring, longitudinal nerve cords and the ganglia is found inside the body. In squids, there are brain and ganglia is also found. And in the early in the higher chordates like mammals, amphibia, reptiles and even there is brain, sensory ganglia and the spinal cord with the vertebrae are found. Now we are discussing the another parameter, appendages. Appendages extends from the main body parts. It can be any sides, upper side, lower side, lateral side. It can be forms from the it is formed and extends from the main body. It is mainly for two purposes, for the feeding and for the locomotion. On the basis of the function which animal shows, it can be classified into these examples. Now we can see by the example. First one is tentacles. Tentacles is found in Hydra. They are used in feeding as well as in defense mechanism. On the tentacles there are nidocyte cells. There is a defense mechanism of cylindrate phylum or Hydra. In Nereids there are parapodia or parapodia is found, leaf like pods in Nereids. It generally used in locomotion as well as in respiration. There is another functions of appendages is respiration, but there is main two function, feeding and locomotion. Another one is fins in fishes. Fins are found in fishes and it is for the locomotion purposes only. Limbs in the higher vertebrates, in higher mammals. In higher animals, tetrapods are found. There are limbs for the locomotion functions only. In simple arms is found in the starfish and have a tube feet. On that, on that for the locomotion and excretion functions, and the jointed legs found in arthropoda. So these are the appendages we found in the animal, and on the basis of these animals we can classify the animals. Now we can picturize these things. In Hydra, there are several tentacles are found, and the nidocyte cells for the defense mechanism is found. Here is jointed appendages of arthropoda phylum. This is biramous appendages, and this is uniramous appendages. What is biramous and what is uniramous appendages? Biramous had a two. For by the appendages bifurcates at the end, and the appendages it not bifurcate at the end. It is unimerous and bifurcates at the end. It is biramous. Here we can picture the nares. Both are nares, and the leaf like parapodia or parapodia is here for the locomotion as well as respiration. Another picture of a fish, there is anterior dorsal fin, a posterior dorsal fin, caudal fin, anal fin, lateral fin, pelvic fin and pectoral fin. These all fins are the for locomotion purposes. In higher vertebrates there are four legs or four pods and four appendages: frog's legs, horse leg, crocodile's legs, ant's leg, chicken's leg, and none other than human's legs are found for the locomotion. And the simple arms structure into the starfish, here seen we are five arms of the starfish. Below there is a tube feed for the locomotion purposes into the water bodies. Now we are discussing not but the least body temperature. What is body temperature? On the basis of body temperature, animals are classified into two. First one is warm-blooded or homeotherm. Second one is cold-blooded animal or poikilotherm. Now what is warm-blooded animal? It is warm-blooded animal that maintain their body temperature. They maintain their body temperature at any atmosphere. If the atmosphere is higher and rising in the temperature, the body temperature not fluctuate, it remains same. If the outer temperature and atmosphere and weather is decreasing and lower, the body temperature also not fluctuating, the animals maintain their body temperature. It is the example of warm-blooded animal. The examples is birds and mammals are warm-blooded animal. There are various kinds of adaptations used by the mammals and birds. In us, where the outer temperature and the weather and the atmosphere is rising, we are start to sweating to maintain our body temperature. And if the outer temperature is lower, we slow down our metabolic activity. We slow down the blood that reaches at the skin level, that release less heat, that release less heat into the skin. After produce in that there is no sweating, so we can maintain our body temperature in the higher temperature, in also lower temperature due to these various kinds of adaptations. Now what is cold-blooded animal? It is cold-blooded animal that do not maintain their body temperature. So the body temperature fluctuates. If there is outer temperature is rising, the body temperature also rising. If the outer temperature is lower, the body temperature also getting the lower. Example, except the birds and mammals, amphibia, reptiles, some echinoderms, these are cold-blooded animals. They do not maintain their body temperature. Adaptations like estivation and hibernation, summer sleep and winter sleep, they are showing because at the certain level of fluctuation of a body, the animal survive. But at the point of higher temperature, we all know that our protein and metabolic activity is stops. So for the protein and protein denatured metabolic activity stops, so the animal shows these types of adaptation like estivation and hibernation with summer sleep and winter sleep. They are at some region. There is no fluctuation and there is no atmosphere changes at low body rate. They estivated and they hibernate. In another, so we are now, so on the basis of this, we can classify the animals. In next session, we are discussing about the organ systems, digestive system, various organ systems like digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, excretory system, nervous system, skeletal system, and reproductive system. So stay tuned at Incredible Biology and stay learned at your home. If any questions, you can ask me in the comment box and through the Google Classroom. Thank you.